Now, as you can see, I have started to fill it in. I did the base coat and I've just started to do the leaves and just filling it in where I want. I don't go by any rule that you have to do this, that and the other first at all. Never have, never will. And sorry, but I don't. So I just build up and build up and build up. So far we do have that. Hope you can see. Now what I'm going to do is just basically go over what I've got. I have added a touch of the distress ink of the walnut stain. Just to I'm just building up the picture. When I want the colour and shading and whatever to be. And with me, I don't, like I said, I don't particularly follow any kind of rule. What is it supposed to look like? I've no idea. I just build it up until I'm happy with what I've got or what I've done. And it's coming along. Remember that your petals are not always straight at the top. They do have, you know, crinkles on them and things like that. And to be honest, you know, your picture is what you see. I hope you can I'm just going to use a little bit more of this. Sorry if I'm quiet, but I find painting so, so relaxing. It's so relaxing. when it's coming on. I'm not sure what you can see or what you think of it, but it's coming on. Now, what I've done is I've got my own makeshift brush that I use for doing something very similar to the one-stroke painting. Because I can't find my normal brush, would you believe? So, I don't have... the one I need. I can't find it, actually. Sorry, I have to keep turning it round and round so that I can actually see what I'm doing. Like that. And you just put your paint on half one way and half the other, and then brush that onto your onto a surface somewhere. You know, and blending it in, and then you can carry on painting with it. I have to turn this round again. This is the thing, you just have to keep swapping it round and round. And then you just wiggle it. Like that, but trying to remember that you have the middle of a leaf as well. So I'm just going to do mine like that. And hopefully what I want to achieve, I can. I'll do it wrong way around, silly old. Oh, I've just put my blooming board straight in it. See? Useless. Useless, 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 useless. Can't even say it. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just add a little bit more colour into that. And just continue going round, doing the leaves. Yes, I will be taking it over some of the flowers, that's fine. And I'm certainly not bothered, you know, about having some white in it at all, because it makes it more lifelike. Like that. I mean, this isn't good enough, really, because I need to use the proper brushes, and I can't find mine, so I've cut another one that I had, that I use a lot of, actually, just because I wanted to finish the picture. I must find mine, whatever it is, because I do use these brushes a lot. You just go over that one again. Like that. Don't think I'm bothered about that one because my picture's fitting on there, isn't it? Yes, so I don't think I'll need that. But I do want to do these, so hopefully you're still watching. Let me just clean my brush, because sometimes I get clogged up and I hate it when it's like that. I'm just going to clean it off a little bit and start again. Uh, and see how we get on from there. Do remember to take some off the page. I hope you're seeing what I'm doing. Sorry if you're not, but it's awkward to hold. You just wiggle it. So it's the wrong brush for me. Really wrong brush, but I can't do anything about that. I can't find mine, and I do want to show you what I'm doing, so you'll just have to excuse me and all the experts. Sorry. Okay. I hope I'm not getting clogged up in this paint as well. But it's not hard to do. It's just getting the hang of it, to be honest. You just get some. You need to keep your brush plastered in paint, to be honest. And I am extending my leaves out to make them a little bit bigger than what I've actually printed off. Stamped off, should I say. Oops, take that out a bit more. And you can go back over them, it doesn't, you know, it's nothing. You do need to get the proper angle. Like that. I'll stop there because there is a leaf underneath, going over the top. Put that in there, it doesn't matter. and it's this one, and I'm going to take it, let's see, bring it over, I think. Like that. Yeah, that just looks pretty neat like that. Think. Because they don't have to be perfect whatsoever. I'm reversing this one right now. Like that. Doesn't matter about the dark bit underneath at all. Let's take that out like that. which looks like there's one there. Right, and so all I'm going to do now is put a little bit more highlighting in the flower itself. And for that I do need a kind of smaller brush. So I'm going to wet the bristles first. And then I have some white and red mixed. And what you've got to remember is, where's the highlight? Okay, so mine's going to be hang on, come on white. You can use your fingers to blend in. Like that. And it just highlights certain areas. And go in with the white a bit more. And then you can go back over it, you see, with the red. It's a little bit harsh, the lines. Just building up and building up layer by layer, you know. I don't know how long this is going to last, this film, but I hope I'm helping somebody, even a beginner. I'm going to go in and put quite a bit more of the red back in, because they are a red flower. just pull my little mat over a bit.